Welcome back. This is indeed the biggest news review on this side of the world. Hashtag Power Breakfast, that's a hashtag to use. At Citizen TV Kenya is our Twitter handle. Mine is at Fred Ndumwili. We're still continuing with our news review here with my panelists, Kimani Wamatangi, Senator Kiambu, Brian Weke, political strategist, Kipruto Arapkirwa, deputy party leader, ANC, also a Senate candidate for Trans Nzoia, and Gakure Monyo, deputy governor, Murang'a County. We now want to look at the biggest headline this morning. Ballot trial throws poll into a spin. That's how the headline on the Standard reads. On the Daily Nation, Musalia drops ballot bomb as IBC calls talks. That is also the top story on Citizen TV, and we want to see this story by Sam Ogina as it trend yesterday.
The opposition has trailed its guns on the president, the electoral agency CEO, and the director of voter registration, claiming a collusion among the three to fix the controversial 2.5 billion shillings ballot printing tender to a friendly firm.
Mr. Aziz Al Gurel is an intimate friend of the Kenyatta family and a frequent guest at the home of Muhoho Kenyatta. In fact, Mr. Muhoho is the local contact of Al Gurel and possibly a shareholder in the firm.
Printing to perfection since 1978. Al Gurel Printing and Publishing.
NASA wants Chiloba and the Director of Voter Registration, Immaculate Kasait, probed for allegedly scheming with status to secure Al Gurel the tender. The opposition alleges Uhuru summoned Chiloba to status where he linked him to Aziz Al Gurel, the CEO of the firm. Kasait is accused of reporting weekly to status to give regular updates of IEBC activities and of allegedly being a member of a Jubilee-leaning Mount Kenya Foundation.
CEO Ezra Chiloba and Mrs. Kasait are currently the single most serious threat to the holding of a free and fair election.
But the president and his deputy William Ruto say the allegations are far-fetched.
So to my brother Raila, please start selling your agenda to the people of Kenya. Leave the IBC to do their work. Tafadhali. Na hiyo namwambia kwa heshima kubwa sana. Hii mambo ya story kila saa story. Ukisimama IBC. IBC haina kura. Kura iko na wananchi.
We want the IBC to award the contract for printing of ballot papers to any company. Hata wakitaka kupatia kampuni ya Spectre ya Raila Odinga, wapatie. Sisi tutashinda uchaguzi.
IBC first issued the ballot printing tender to Al Gurel firm after an open tender before the opposition challenged the award and subsequent nullification. The electoral agency then moved to restricted tendering given time constraints, where 13 firms were invited before the process was halted by the Public Procurement Administrative Review Board. Running out of time, the commission re-awarded the tender to Al Gurel, given the firm has been printing all the by-election ballot papers since 2014. The commission having ruled out local printing or sharing the printing tender as options. The Jubilee Party claims the latest NASA allegations point to a coalition that has sensed defeat.
The elections in August, 8th of August, is written in stone in our constitution. It has to take place. They've tried everything to stop it, but I think the IBC has pronounced themselves on this. It will take place.
NASA nonetheless calling for the cancellation of the tender in favor of a fresh process and the resignation of the implicated IEBC officials.
So I think this has got to be stopped forthwith. And I think Uhuru knows there's a serious doubt due to conflict of interest.
It is in bad taste for them to invite players to police them. Their work, their duty, their production must be beyond any suspicion, like Caesar's wife.
54 days to the election and the opposition is casting a dark shadow on the credibility of the IEBC. The opposition directly linking the president on interfering with the electoral process. Sam Ogina, Citizen TV, Nairobi.
Yes, let's start with Kipruto Arapkirwa, the deputy party leader, ANC. We saw your party leader, Musalia Mudavadi, there coming out of this bombshell. In fact, the Daily Nation quotes him directly. Musalia drops ballot bomb as IBC calls talks. IBC has gone ahead and said, okay, fine, if you have a problem with this, come together, we'll go. We'll take you to Dubai and you can actually oversee the printing. What exactly is the problem? Does this have the potential of actually affecting the date of the elections?
Well, I hope it's not going to affect, because it's a constitutional matter, the way many other people have pronounced themselves.
But what has been worrying us, and this is a very genuine issue, and let us not talk about who is going to win the election, because up to now, it is Kenyans who know who they are going to vote for. That's why we are seeking votes, and we are spending a lot of sleepless nights trying to network all over the country. But to get to the substance of this issue, I think it is important that IEBC pronounces itself on every step in a way that is totally clear that they are non-partisan. You know, there are small events, leave alone this, that make cast aspersion on the integrity of IEBC. From the issue of the case in court, anybody else could have gone to court to challenge that particular pronunciation under section 86 of the constitution about how elections are going to be pronounced or declared, the results. Number two is this issue of Wavinya Ndeti. What did the chairman have to do with the membership of political parties when we know the custodian of the membership is the registrar of political parties? And Lucy Ndung'u has pronounced herself very clearly that Wavinya Ndeti is a member of WIPER. Now finally, this issue. How do you invite me to come and witness a process that I really do not understand? You cannot tell us that, okay, all of a sudden, because you don't agree, come and see the printing being done. Well, but I'm happy they have said our presidential candidates or key players will be invited at 10 o'clock. I hope the meeting at 10 o'clock is going to assist us to decipher some of the challenges that we have. But we still maintain the position that IEBC must allow itself to be transparent so that whatever happens is going to be informed by the process that has taken place. Elections are very important matters. Let's not take them for granted. It is about this country, it's about us, our children, and the children of our children.
Yes. Munarukure Monyo, some of the issues that have been raised are very clear, and it's rather obvious, if at all, or some of these people who have been, Al Gray, who has been awarded that tender, was hosted in State House, then surely that presents doubts on the other side, surely. Don't you see that as a potential problem?
Fred, I'll come from the premise that every entrepreneur has friends in different ways. I do not know who owns Nation, but I'll lead the Nation today. I might not know who owns Al Gural, but I'll vote on the 8th of August. IEBC has taken us through the process of what they are doing progressively in everything that they've done, starting from when the opposition sat on tarmac demanding change, and change was brought about. They've had challenges, the tender thing has been to court, they've consulted the public procurement oversight authority to arrive at that, and they have come up with people who had tendered for this. Wherever you would print these ballot papers from, there'll still be issues of people casting aspersions on this. And I appreciate this meeting that has been called at 10 o'clock, that, you see, come and air out your challenges. Get your agents to go and see whether the printing is properly done. After Al Gural finishes printing, IEBC is the one which will come and conduct the general elections. So whether you print them where, IEBC is the one that will come. They are not saying that IEBC is, and I don't take what Honorable Kira said, it's not transparent. It's been transparent. Which institution tells you we've fired our procurement manager, we've fired our ICT manager? Institutions run the way they do. But we have seen IEBC telling us every step of what they do. And I don't see why the opposition will be saying that the ballot papers, since they are being printed by somebody. Whoever owns, for example, Citizen, is a friend of someone. And we cannot be seen like, because now we are in Citizen, that friendship can change what we will say here. I think it's important we all understand that ballot papers must be printed. This time they will be printed from Al Gural in Dubai. They will come here. Let the agents of the presidential candidate, or anybody else who feels that they feel it's not properly done, let them go and see. My question will be, you walking into a printing factory, what do you understand?
Yes.
So, even if they go, I think all they need to do is to have a faith with IBC, and the Wafula Chebukati Commission has, to me, yeah, done a commendable job, and I'll rate them as so far up to now about 8 out of 10.
Okay, Brian Wike, probably in your own understanding, what exactly is NASA's fear? That fine, the tender could be awarded to anyone. Printing will continue, and IBC says come and see the way the printing is done. What do you think is NASA's fear? Because probably some of the people reading these headlines do not understand, okay, tender procurement, what exactly is a fear if Al Ghurair goes ahead and prints the ballot papers, according to NASA?
Now, key things, and I want us to listen keenly, because now I want to speak as an electoral expert. The integrity of the election, the integrity of the vote, is as good as the electoral process. Now, you cannot, and it is very sad that the Deputy President of the Republic of Kenya can actually say on national TV and in public that we can actually give it to Spectra. Because you and I know that we've had a history as a country, and elections have been stolen in the past. It is public knowledge, everybody knows about this. Fred, anybody who has control of ballot papers clearly has a head start in an election. Now, the allegations that are being brought forth that there is an intimate relationship, and I want to call them allegations because I also am not sure, but for sure, if there is an intimate relationship, I don't want to get to the level where we have to define intimate. Wamatangi can tell us, but if there is an intimate relationship between players of elections and the person who prints the ballot papers, that's a serious cause for alarm. And saying that, look here, let's carry Brian Weke, so and so, let's go to Dubai and see how they are printing. Mm-hmm. Nobody is questioning the capacity and capability of Al Ghurair to print ballot papers. Mm-hmm. We know that in the last 2 years, they've been printing ballot papers. Now, key indicators that makes me worried as an electoral expert. Number one, if you look at the history of Al Ghurair in terms of printing electoral materials, they've only printed electoral materials in quote-unquote jurisdictions that have actually failed. They printed ballot papers in Libya, they printed ballot papers for Afghanistan, they have printed ballot papers for Uganda and Zambia, but again, the agreement was actually, the relationship was quite acrimonious. Now, the opposition went to challenge the process of awarding the tender to Al Ghurair. And of course, the courts in their wisdom, they said, look here, this was not properly awarded. Again, the commission sat down and gave direct, through direct procurement, allocated the same farm. And you have to ask yourself, what is motivating the commission? There are a number of printing firms that have capacity, that have integrity, that have capability, that have printed ballot papers in serious jurisdictions, in serious economies that practice democracy. But guess what? Mm-hmm. They were never considered. So again, even as we discuss this matter, it is not an issue of we give it to Spectra, because again, Spectra would skew the election process, because Spectre, we know very well that the Prime Minister has interest.
The fear by NASA is a Jubilee by through those allegations that it has intimate relationships, that some members of within Jubilee have an intimate relationship with the owners of Ghurair, that therefore Jubilee has control over ballot papers.
Direct
that
control. It's a huge fear.
Okay.
It is a very serious fear. You know, ballot stuffing is something that has happened in this country, mm-hmm, and happens over and over again.
So the fear is that Al Ghurair could print more ballot papers?
Absolutely. Is that a question?
Because that's what I want us to break it down, so that people can understand what exactly does it mean that, okay, fine, they have control over the ballot papers. What does it mean?
You see, let me tell you. You saw even in the nominations that have just mm-hmm been finalized, both in Jubilee and in NASA areas, you heard that the serious allegations was somebody was in possession of ballot papers.
Yes.
If you're in possession of ballot papers, believe you me, you have a head start.
Genuine ballot papers.
Mm-hmm. And you can imagine even in the nomination process, the ballot papers that were there, others were not even genuine. But this, you have somebody who, and these are allegations, I don't want to confirm. If it is true, Fred, that I have an intimate relationship with you and I'm the one printing the ballot papers, what makes me not print more ballot papers for your interest?
Okay.
So the integrity of the vote heavily depends on the integrity of the electoral process.
Yes.
So let's not take this matter lightly.
Senator Omatangi, that relationship between Al-Ghuraya, the allegations of a relationship between Al-Ghuraya and members of Jubilee, surely is something that cannot be wished away.
You know, I was trying to run through my mind to look for a good word to describe the whole of this thing. And trust me, I've been to school, so and I can say I can find a few English words. I struggle to look for one. I can't find a befitting one. But
those are serious allegations. Don't you agree?
I'll tell you probably what I would describe it as. The whole circus. It's hogwash.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I'll tell you why. You know, the law is very clear.
Mm-hmm.
Very, very clear. When you are printing ballot papers, you print ballot papers using an audited, verified voters register. And I want you to listen to me. Once you have gone through the voters register and you have said these are the number of registered voters audited and agreed upon, that is the number that you use to print ballot papers.
There's no provision for spoiled.
No, let me finish. Once you print those ballot papers, it is a requirement, and you have gone through this as we were discussing the entire story of even disbanding the earlier IEBC. If you have 10,000 registered voters in a particular ward or sub-county, you will have 10,000 ballot papers delivered to that particular county. If you have 700 registered voters in this polling station, you will have 700 ballots delivered to that polling station. That's why I said, listen to me. Now, once those ballot papers are delivered, it does not matter whether they were printed in the west or in the east or in the south. The only thing that you would be questioning about who printed these ballot papers is the quality of that ballot paper. If it is blood, if it doesn't have watermarks, if it does not meet the specific standard of a ballot paper. Because the requirement is of our law is if you went, and I want to use the Jubilee nominations as an example. You saw nominations in Nandi. When people went to go for the nominations in the morning and they found that the ballot papers were not sufficient, they said, we cannot vote. We want sufficient ballot papers equal to the number of registered voters here. Now, this is a general election that we're going to. And what I would expect would be coming from this gentleman as a matter of concern is in the polling stations of Bondo, of Kisumu, of Nairobi, of Kiambu, of the other places, are they going to deliver, or is this company or whoever is printing going to deliver sufficient ballot papers?
And by sufficient, you mean the exact number of voters?
That is the law. That is the requirement. That is why we are having a voters register. And that is why it has got to be audited as per the law. Now, once you have those ballot papers delivered, then it is the work of the established system of this country as per the law to supervise the process of the election as to how people will come in and mark. And I want to remind my friends, in quotes on the other side, really, you should try harder if you're looking. They've been looking very, very, very consistently and hard for a way to derail the process and the actual date of the elections. And I'll tell you why. I want to remind them first that the elections, the by-elections that they held in Malindi and were won by their candidate, those ballot papers were printed by Al-Ghuraya. The by-election they held in Kajiado and were won by their person were printed by Al-Ghuraya. They never came at one time to say that these ballot papers were printed by the wrong person or they are of wrong quality. Now when it comes to the main election, they bring in the election. My last point. This challenge by NASA was taken to court on the award of this particular tender. And as per the requirements and provisions of the law in the Public Procurement and Disposal Act, if you have sufficient as reason as a procuring entity, for example, the question of urgency, then you are allowed by law to award a tender to the company that you have chosen.
Okay.
Now, the by-election is on 8th of August, and these gentlemen know that. That's the date of the election. Now they come and challenge that, cancel that tender and give to another person. And if you listen and underline between the lines of what are these people alleging, they have no allegation. They're not saying that these people are going to print more papers. These people are, they're not saying that they're going to print bad ballot papers. They're not saying that they're going to come and stuff themselves. They're only saying in a vague way that this gentleman knows the other gentleman.
Okay.
That
okay.
has nothing
okay.
to do with the election.
Gentlemen.
And the story here, Fred, let me finish. The story here is because
I'll give you an opportunity.
The story here, and we have to say this to Kenyans in with a straight face. What has happened, and I want to challenge these two gentlemen who represent the NASA fraternity. This comes after you have seen the Jubilee leaders having gone around the country to campaign, and to their surprise, now they have seen that there is a massive reaction and a following that now has told them the story that the election has been won. So they want
gentlemen,
to stop it and want it and
up.
Stop it at
what
I will
do, I'll give you each 45 seconds to give your final comment on this particular issue or on any other headline that we've touched on. Let's start with you, Bwana Kikuria Rakiwa.
Well, on this particular issue, it's important for Mheshimiwa Matangi to know that the procurement officer was sacked the other day. Number two, it's also important for him to know the same company had been awarded earlier on, and when the litigation was done, they were denied. It's for a very strange twist of fate that this company again is given direct award after all that rigmarole we've gone through. What is so special about this company?
Okay.
Well, I'll concur with what Senator Matangi said, and I'd said as well in different words, it doesn't matter where the ballot papers are printed. I would urge NASA people, ensure you have agents in all polling stations to authenticate the number of ballots delivered are equal to the number of registered voters, and then you watch as Jubilee wins the general election.
About those who will have died between now and the election. Brian Wecker.
Fred, I think Wamatangi is misrepresenting facts. And maybe he does not understand electoral processes. Now, let's be very honest. Number one, it is untrue that you can stand on national TV and say that you only print ballot papers based on the number of people in a polling station. If a polling station has 800 people, then you ought to print ballot papers way more than 800 so that you provide for spoiled votes, or when somebody has marked wrongly and they say, look here, I have marked wrongly, I need another ballot paper, then you are allowed to actually get another ballot paper. Now it is very sad that we are saying, you know, as I'm trying to bring out certain issues of integrity of election is heavily dependent on the integrity of the electoral process. You and I know that in this country, and this has never happened anywhere, there are certain jurisdictions and certain areas where you find 100% voter turnout. That does not happen even in serious jurisdictions like Australia, where voting is mandatory. If you go to Central Kenya and Rift Valley and Luo Nyanza, you get 100% voter turnout. Why is that? Of course it's because of ballot stuffing. Now, the DG is talking about having agents in all the areas. In every successive elections, you have agents in all these areas. But you know what happens? After the elections, they look at turnout and say, we've only had 60%. So what do? We do top-up. And when you do top-up, you do that ballot stuffing. Now, if somebody has control of ballot papers, I'm hearing you saying that it does not matter where you print them. My friend, if you have control of ballot papers, you have an upper hand in terms of elections.
Okay.
So you cannot sit on national TV and lie to us that there is nothing wrong, even if Spectre is printing ballot papers.
Okay.
No, I don't want to go back to what I said because I made my point very clear.
Yes.
And what Brian is saying has nothing to do with printing of ballots. You know, stuffing of ballots or whether there was 100% turnout is not about the printer.
Yes.
That's about the monitoring of the process. That's done by the electoral observer that we have, the polling clerks, the presiding officers, and the security forces, including their agents. If they have agents, they must have agents there. That has nothing to do with printing. That's not what I wanted to comment on. My comment I wanted to comment because on Saturday, the day after tomorrow, the former Prime Minister and the leader of NASA, Raila Amolo Odinga, has said that it's on his schedule. He'll be visiting Kiambu,
yes,
and holding a rally in Kiambu. And I wanted to say two things. One, that I want to assure him and tell him that he is welcome to Kiambu. Like any other part of this country, he can come to Kiambu. Kiambu is a peaceful county. The people there, we have been living well, and we do our things properly. Just two things I wanted to say as he comes. One, I want to urge him when he comes to Kiambu to ensure that he does not come at all, either with groups, with outsiders, with supporters who will come, as we have seen before, with an intent to cause chaos or start violence. Two, I also want to require and request of him, as part of the leadership of Kiambu, that when he comes, let his message be a message of national union, not to come and incite anyone and not be a dividing message. And thirdly, when he comes to the platform of Kiambu, like His Excellency the President has done, we would be more than happy to hear him declare in Kiambu that he is ready to concede the elections if he loses the elections, in a process that will be undertaken by Kenyans voting.
Okay.
And so I want to say to him, he's welcome.
He's welcome to Kiambu.
We only want to find to ensure that when he comes, he's coming for a peaceful rally.
Okay.
There is no other scheme. And he doesn't bring people from outside who want to come.
Thank you, Senator. Thank you, Senator Kimani Omatangi from Kiambu. Bwana Brian Weke, political strategist, Kiputu Rakiro, deputy party leader, ANC, and also a Senate candidate for Trans Nzoia, as well as Gakure Monyo, deputy governor, Murang'a County, helping us look at the headlines this morning. Thank you so much, gentlemen. Thank you for the nice, genuine, and brilliant conversations that we've had this morning. My colleague Willis Baburu will be hosting a Chef William. Gentlemen, I need to tease Willis Baburu's next segment. He'll be hosting Chef William, as well as having another interview still within Pub Breakfast. Remember, the hashtag to use throughout the show is hashtag Pub Breakfast. My name is Fred Ndimuli. For me and my panelists, it's good morning.